First of all, David, you obviously put up some stats, and really my concern here is there's a false narrative and intellectual dishonesty going on with the plan. So you showed some stats showing the share of commute, and you explained the decline in car commuting as being caused by a switch to bike and transit. You seem to completely gloss over the fact that working from home was the major reason, or one of the main most significant contributors. So I felt that was dishonest. You showed the stats and glossed over that. Secondly, you present the premise that if we build, we will get people moving to where, near where they work. What will happen in Marin with buildings like Wincup, which is 10% affordable, is 90% of those units will go to high-paid tech workers and city workers who will add to the traffic congestion, which is our acute issue. The remaining 10% or whatever is given to affordable, as I can show it later, this is a question. So what's going on with the affordable parts of the units are, with HUD rulings, those cannot be allocated to local workers. That would be dishonest. So you're showing a dishonest thing that we need to build housing near jobs. And then lastly, can you answer the number one and number two projects? SMART is, according to Plan Bay Area, Appendix E, mid-century sea level rise will 50% inundate that project. So can you tell me why we're putting all our eggs into a basket for this underwater train that is supposed to solve our transportation issues? Thank you.
So I think I got all that. I will try to answer each of the three parts. So first of all, I agree with telecommuting is part of that. I will say, of those 5 percentage points, and two of them are from transit, part of it is from telecommuting. In San Francisco, the walking and biking trends have been the primary drivers. So different parts of the region had different drivers. And most of those changes in mode shift have been in the central Bay Area. So that's what I was referring to, is that Marin County may have had changes in terms of more people working at home, but unfortunately, other mode shares have changed as well. To your second point about jobs and housing being closer together, you know, if we can have the right match of jobs and housing in close proximity, what we see is that the VMT, the vehicle miles traveled, the people who live in those developments are lower. I mean, if you look at the development patterns of the Bay Area today, housing is being produced in two distinct areas. In the places like San Francisco, close to the high-wage jobs, and then in very distant suburbs. And those folks are typically driving long distances to get to work. And what we call the inner ring suburbs of the region, very little housing is being produced. And so this gap, and when I'm referring to those inner ring suburbs, I'm talking about places like parts of Silicon Valley where very little housing is being produced and lots of jobs are being created. That gap has created a very difficult commuting pattern. The third part of the question, related to sea level rise, just quickly, look, SMART isn't the only transportation asset that is at high risk of sea level rise. As you'll see on our vital signs tool, numerous freeways, including US 101 here in Marin, including US 1 on the peninsula, are at risk of sea level rise. And that's why we have resilience as one of our key areas of the action plan to protect our infrastructure.